Tell me why.
To follow the Lord and find freedom, to love as He loves and brings peace, to spend our lifetime for His kingdom, to want it to grow and increase, to search for the truth never ceasing, to look for the star in the night, to knock at the door never tiring, to wait eagerly for His light, to follow the Lord and find freedom, to love as He loves and brings peace.
Good morning, my dear brothers and sisters.
Good morning,
and welcome to this Eucharistic celebration. In a moment of silence, let us offer to the Lord all our intentions, all our prayers, our families, our work, our studies. Let us ask the Lord to guide our life this day, this week. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters in Jesus Christ, when we see the situation around us today, we realize the people are struggling, people need our support, people need to be helped. And rightly, the readings of this day, the 13th Sunday of Ordinary Time, invite each one of us as followers of Christ to be generous, to be hospitable, to be committed, and to be charitable. When we analyze our life, we understand that at times we have closed eyes to the needs of the people. At times we have told to ourselves, it is not my duty, let others do the needful. Today, as we come around this altar of God, let us ask the Lord to guide our lives, guide our thoughts, so that we help out to the people who are around us. Before now we celebrate this Eucharist, let us call to mind our sins and shortcomings and prepare ourselves worthily to celebrate this Eucharist. Let us together say, I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts, in my words, in what I have done, in what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, O Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy.
people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, Heavenly King, O God Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world. Receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High Jesus Christ. With the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who through the grace of adoption chose us to be children of light, grant, we pray, that we may not be wrapped in the darkness of error, but always be seen to stand in the bright light of truth. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the second book of Kings. One day, Elisha went on to Shunem, where a wealthy woman lived, who urged him to eat some food. So whenever he passed that way, he would turn in there to eat food. And he said to her husband, "Behold now, I perceive that this is a holy man of God, who is continually passing our way. Let us make a small roof chamber with walls and put there for him a bed, a table, a chair, and a lamp, so that whenever he comes to us, he can go in there." One day he came there, and he turned into the chamber and rested there. And he said, "What then is to be done for her?" Gehazi answered, "Well, she has no son, and her husband is old." He said, "Call her." And when he had called her, she stood in the doorway. And he said, "At this season, when the time comes round, you shall embrace a son." The word of God.
Thanks be to God. I will sing of the mercies of the Lord, forever I will sing of the mercies of the Lord. All together. I will sing of the mercies of the Lord, forever I will sing of the mercies of the Lord.
I will sing forever of your love, O Lord. Through all ages my mouth will proclaim your truth. Of this I am sure, that your love lasts forever, that your truth is firmly established as the heavens.
I will sing of the mercies of the Lord, forever I will sing of the mercies of the Lord.
Happy the people who acclaim such a king, who walk, O Lord, in the light of your face, who find their joy every day in your name, who make your justice the source of their bliss.
I will sing of the mercies of the Lord, forever I will sing of the mercies of the Lord.
For it is you, O Lord, who are the glory of their strength. It is by your favor that our might is exalted. For our ruler is in the keeping of the Lord, our king in the keeping of the Holy One of Israel.
I will sing of the mercies of the Lord, forever I will sing of the mercies of the Lord.
A reading from the letter of Saint Paul to the Romans. Do you not know that all of us who have been baptized into Christ Jesus were baptized into his death? We were buried, therefore, with him by baptism into death, so that as Christ was raised from the dead by the glory of the Father, we too might walk in newness of life. But if we have died with Christ, we believe that we shall also live with him. For we know that Christ, being raised from the dead, will never die again. Death no longer has dominion over him. The death he died to sin once for all. But the life he lives to God. So you also must consider yourselves dead to sin and alive to God in Christ Jesus. The word of God.
Thanks be to God.
Please stand up for the gospel.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Teach me to keep your precepts, keep them with all my heart. Hallelujah, hallelujah.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Saint Matthew.
Glory be to you, O Lord.
Jesus instructed the 12 as follows. He who loves father or mother more than me is not worthy of me. And he who loves son or daughter more than me is not worthy of me. And he who does not take his cross and follow me is not worthy of me. He who finds his life will lose it, and he who loses his life for my sake will find it. He who receives you receives me, and he who receives me receives him who sent me. He who receives a prophet because he is a prophet shall receive a prophet's reward. He who receives a righteous man because he is righteous shall receive a righteous man's reward. And whoever gives to one of these little ones even a cup of cold water because he is a disciple, truly I say to you, he shall not lose his reward. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Lord Jesus Christ.
My dear brothers and sisters in Christ, the readings of today highlights the importance of being hospitable, generous, or charitable to God and to our brothers and sisters, or to make our brothers and sisters feel at home. My dear brothers and sisters in Christ, on June 1st, 2005, the Hindu newspaper carried a story of two NRIs from USA, Mr. Hemant Kumar and his wife Sujata, brought home to India their pet dogs, spending over $1,000. If this is not a great thing, or not a big deal for you, then how about this? About in 2019, just last year in January, a camp was held to rest and restoration camp for 28 elephants by the government of Tamil Nadu, just to make the elephants feel at home. And for a month, they spend lakhs of rupees feeding them with rice, sugarcane, fruits, vegetables, multivitamin tablets, and bathing them twice a day, and keeping 10 to 12 workers round the clock to take care of them. My dear brothers and sisters in Christ, making animals feel at home is an commendable enterprise. But reflecting on today's readings, it make me ask a question: who must feel at home? Or what does hospitality has got to do to making the other feel at home? The liturgy of today invites us to feel at home not only our pets, but our brothers and sisters whom we encounter in our daily life. The theme of welcoming and showing hospitality to strangers, to children of God, appears in the first reading and even in the Gospel. The first reading, we see this elderly couple welcoming Prophet Elisha to their home. Not only just welcoming and dining with Prophet Elisha and his servant Gehazi, but rather preparing a room in the attic for him to stay, putting a bed, a table, a chair, so that he can have a comfortable stay in their house. And we see that at the end, Prophet Elijah is so much touched by the generosity, by the hospitality, that he asks his servant, what must we do in the return for this couple. And his servant says, they have no child, and her husband is old. And we hear prophet saying to call her, and he tells this woman that next year during this time, you will embrace a son. In the gospel, my dear brothers and sisters, we see Jesus explains, particularly his apostles, that when they go out, that they should be respecting, they should be kind, they should be nice towards whoever they encounter in their life. And Jesus says or tells his disciples that whoever you encounter in life should be welcomed, should be respected, should be taken care of. And so Jesus says that whoever receives me receives the one who sent me. And those who help the little ones, the poor, the sick, the needy will be amply rewarded. So my dear brothers and sisters in Christ, the hospitality or generosity or kindness that is mentioned or that we see in today's reading is nothing new to us Indians. We know Indians by our very nature are very warm and hospitable people. We often welcome or we often call or invite whomever comes probably to our door or whomever we meet on a way as we encounter. So my dear brothers and sisters in Christ, it is not difficult for us to play a host or to welcome our guests, especially maybe our priests, maybe sisters, brothers, maybe our friends and relatives. But what is difficult is to welcome rest of God's children. Maybe those strangers whom we meet maybe first time. Maybe those passerbyers, maybe the hungry, the homeless, the helpless, whom we encounter, whom we meet in our daily life. We are invited today, my dear brothers and sisters, to be hospitable, to be generous, to be kind, to make people feel at home, whomever we meet in our daily life. But welcoming someone in our home or heart is not an easy task. Especially in given situation with pandemic, also in given situation of so many pressures and tensions that we go through in our life, so much of rivalry and competition that we see in the academics or maybe in the place of work, or maybe so much of violence and crimes that are happening around us, it is difficult for us to welcome someone in our home or in our heart. Father Henry Joseph Nguyen, a Dutch priest, defines hospitality in a beautiful way. He says, hospitality is nothing but creating a friendly space where a stranger can enter and live in freedom. And so, it is inviting the guests not so much to change themselves or to mold them or to convince them about our beliefs or the way of life that we live, but providing that comfortable empty space to enter and to discover themselves the best that they are. And so this happens, my dear brothers and sisters, only when we give them that space by listening to our guests, by feeling with them, feeling their pains, their struggles, by dreaming the dreams that they dream and affirming those dreams and thereby making the guest feel comfortable, making the guest feel at home. On the other hand, we see a good guest, a good host will set limits But as he sets limits, he's also flexible towards the guest to confront him. If needed, also to challenge him to explore his potency, to explore his talents and gifts in the journey of life that he's living, thereby inviting his guest to grow, to become a better person. And so, my dear brothers and sisters, we have been invited in today's gospel to be hospitable, to be charitable, to be kind, to help all those whom we meet to grow, to become a better person by encounter, by giving that space in their life to grow. And we see this is being done by our parents towards their children. We see the teachers doing this towards their students. We see the professionals doing towards their patients. We see friends doing this towards their comrade. So when we reach out, my dear brothers and sisters, out of normal life of ours towards those who need, those who want us, the poor, the lowly, the strangers, or those on the streets, into our homes and into our hearts, Jesus says, we will not lose our reward. So showing hospitality, my dear brothers and sisters, to the poor, to the downtrodden, maybe to the migrants, to the unloved, maybe the elderly, those who are sick, those who live alone, you are not only receiving reward for your generosity, for your compassion, for your kindness, but you create that space. You give that chance to your guest, to the person that you encounter, to find his own destiny. In other words, you give them a chance to sing their own song. You give them the chance to dance their own dance. You give them to speak their own language. Finally, I want to end with a small story. I'm sure you might have heard about it. It's about a pig and a cow having a discussion. The pig says to the cow, how come that people are always happy with you? They always look up to you. They always cheer. They are very happy and praise you for everything that you do. But whereas me, everyone shuns me. Nobody appreciates me. Nobody likes me, the pig says. The cow says to the pig, that is because I give them a lot of milk. I give them a lot of cow dung for their gardening. And so I sacrifice instead of giving to my little one, I give to people. But the pig says, I too give bacon, ham, sausages, so many things I also give to people, but people never appreciate me. The cow says, yes, I do all these things when I'm alive, but you do it when you are dead. How, my dear brothers and sisters, we need to make two things here. One is that the pig gives himself completely. The whole pig is being used for our betterment, be it his legs, be it his intestine, be it his head or his flesh, everything. He makes a total sacrifice of himself. Whereas cow, we see, only gives maybe the milk, the cow dung, when it is alive. But at the same time, we see that the cow does this when it is alive. So let us be generous, let us be kind, let us be hospitable towards our brothers and sisters when we are alive. Let us make them feel at home when we are alive. Not by keeping a bank account, by keeping fixed deposits, keeping a property, keeping all these things in order to make them happy and comfortable, but by maybe spending, maybe by sacrificing all these things. When we are alive, let us sacrifice. Not when we are gone that people are happy or that people say some things. Amen.
Let us stand up and profess our faith. Let us recite Nicene Creed. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made, for us men and for our salvation. He came down from heaven,
and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary,
and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. And I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Dear brothers and sisters, God rewards us for every good work we do. The kindness that the woman of Shunem shows to Elisha is rewarded with the promise of a son. Let us now place our intention before the Lord, saying, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer. For our Holy Father, Pope Francis, the bishops, clergy and religious, that as leaders of the Church, they may work towards the advancement of the Kingdom of God and its values. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the leaders of our country, that they may make good use of their power and authority to be kind and generous towards their fellow men in these troubled times. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Christians all over the world, for all the faithful communities in the world, and in particular our parish communities, that will be truly warm and welcoming community. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for all those who are ill with the coronavirus, with cancer and with other illnesses, especially those who are in the hospital or are waiting for the result of their tests. May each one of them experience compassion, kindness and healing touch of Jesus. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For all childless couples who, in spite of their strong desire to bring forth a child and nurture it in Christian faith, are denied this possibility, may experience joy and satisfaction in their lives. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For our personal intentions and intentions of the community, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. God our Father, we thank you for the gift of your Son, Jesus Christ, who always rewarded anyone who has come to him with honest intention. All those who have approached him have experienced physical healing. Give us the grace that we too may become kind and charitable to persons who are in need. We make this prayer through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you. Fruit of the earth and work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you. Fruit of the wine, work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
O God, who graciously accomplish the effects of your mysteries, grant, we pray, that the deeds by which we serve you may be worthy of these sacred gifts. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For by his birth he brought renewal to humanity's fallen state, and by his suffering cancelled out our sins, and by his rising from the dead he has opened the way to eternal life, and by ascending to you, O Father, he has unlocked the gates of heaven, and so, with the company of angels and saints, we sing the hymn of your praise as without end we acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took the bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, it took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit.
Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Oswald Gracious, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Joseph, with the Blessed Apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be coerced to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Smile on our faces. Let us offer each other a sign of peace.
Peace be with you. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
O Lord Jesus, since I cannot receive you in your sacramental presence, I beg you to come spiritually into my soul to enrich me with your holy grace and make me truly your own forever. O Jesus, living in Mary, come and live in me, in the spirit of your holiness, in the fullness of your power, in the communion of your mysteries, in the perfection of your ways. O Divine Guest, give to my soul a strong, lively faith, an unbounded trust, perfect humility, an abiding sorrow for my sins, a total abandonment to your divine will, and a perfect loving union with you in mind and heart. O Sacrament most holy, O Sacrament divine, all praise and all thanksgiving be every moment thine. Lord Jesus, thank you for the blessings and graces you have given me through this spiritual communion.
Let us pray. May this divine sacrifice we have offered and received fill us with life, O Lord, we pray, so that bound to you in lasting charity, we may bear fruit that lasts forever. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go forth, the Mass is ended.
Thanks be to God.
Dear brothers and sisters, on this 13th Sunday of Ordinary Time. I wish you a wonderful week ahead, and may God bless each one of you. This Sunday, we have outreach program which is organized by youth. Our youth, with the collaboration of very many parishioners, are going to Indranagar and Mariam Nagar to reach out to 100 families, and also in Vijayanagar, they will be helping 20 families. I, on behalf of youth group, thank each one of you for your generosity and also ask your prayers during this outreach. Thank you.
Prayer for relief from the coronavirus. Almighty and merciful God, who show your love to all creation everywhere, hear graciously the prayers we make for all those affected by the coronavirus in various parts of the world. We come before you asking for a quick control of the outbreak, for a healing of those affected, for the victims and their families. We pray for the doctors doing research that an effective vaccine to combat the sickness is speedily found. We pray for the government and health authorities that they take appropriate steps for the good of the people. We make this prayer to Christ our Lord. Amen.
Father, I thank you for your goodness. You show yourself to children, and in my life I see you leading me into my childhood once again. Under the shadow of your guiding hand, I walk the journey of my life. Across the years I see you leading me, and I am young again. Father, I thank you for your goodness. You show yourself to children.